Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me today is Richard Osmond, Interim CEO at Element 29 Resources. Richard, good to meet you. How are you?
Thank you, Christine. I'm doing very well. How about yourself?
I am great. Thanks for asking. Richard, we did hold an interview with the company summer of 2021. So investors who are new to the story here, aren't familiar with the company, give us a quick introduction.
Yeah, okay, so Element 29 is a copper-focused junior resource company with projects in Peru. We're listed on the TSX Venture Exchange, as well as on the OTCQB in the US, and as well as the Frankfurt Exchange. We have two projects, and both projects have seen a fair bit of work historically, and they have some pretty good copper intercepts, so they're not exactly early stage. And, you know, both projects at the same time are very well located. I would even say strategically well located for future mine development in Peru. We're working towards initial resource estimates on both projects, which will significantly expand our, you know, our valuations, I think, once we get that done. From a team perspective, I think we have a very experienced team with lots of operational and exploration experience in Peru. Our share structure is very tight. We have close to 80 million shares issued, and they're owned mostly by insiders, you know, institutional investors. We have a private equity group in there, and the rest is retail. So we're a very catalyst-driven company. You know, we have a fairly extensive program for 2022, and, you know, it's going to be very exciting.
We'll talk more about that in just a second, but give us a sense of what your background looks like and why you joined the company.
We actually founded the company back in 2017. It was sort of a spin out from a private junior called Globetrotters Resource Group. And we had put together this portfolio. It took about 7+ years to do that. We just felt that we'd get more value for the assets if we put them into a junior company and listed it versus, you know, trying to farm them out to the majors. So I've been involved in these projects from a very early stage and a founder of that company. So once our CEO decided to retire for health reasons back in late 2022, it was just really a logical progression for me to step in as interim CEO at that point.
Understood. Thanks for letting us know about that. So let's focus in on drilling. You did recently start drilling at your Florida Cobre copper project just last week. So what are the objectives there?
Yeah, that's a good question. The actual drilling just started last Thursday. And really, the project has a bit of history. There was an initial resource estimate completed by a junior company at the time called Rio Amarillo, in partnership with Phelps Dodge, which is now Freeport McMoRan, of course. And they drilled off an historical resource of about 57.4 million tons of 0.67 as a leachable supergene enrichment blanket. Now, the objective for this program is to really go in and validate that drilling and to get it to an initial resource estimate that's sort of compliant with CIM best practice standards kind of thing. So we'll be doing that. But I mean, back in those days, the copper price was like $1 per pound. So there was real no interest in drilling into these hypogene or primary sulfide targets below in the porphyry system. So we actually plan to go in and use those 9 holes that we wanted to use to validate the initial resource and just drill them deeper and test the primary sulfide potential below. And that's sort of like the tip of the iceberg where you have the enrichment sort of forming on top of these primary sulfides. So there is potential to significantly expand the resource base on the Florida Cobre project.
I know you just started, but what's kind of the timeline that you have in mind for drilling?
Yeah, it won't take that long. I mean, we're looking at close to 4,000 meters of drilling. So we'd say around 3 to 4 months. And, you know, assay results, we're getting pretty good turnaround on those. We're getting about a 3-week turnaround once we get the core out to the lab. So we should be starting to get results out fairly quickly.
And I think it was late last year where you did close a private placement of around $6.8 million. So that's enough to take you through this program?
Yeah, it's more than enough. We have another program planned for later in the year at our Elliott project. So we may have to top up to complete that. But for now, we have lots of money to complete the existing program.
Yeah. So what is the focus for the remainder of the year?
Yeah, that's a good question. We plan to get the drilling done at Florida Cobre. We're really just testing the what's called the Elida, or sorry, the Candelaria Porphyry Center. The Florida Cobre project is actually made up of two different porphyry centers. The other one's called Acero Rosado, which we acquired, late in 2018, and we're still in the process of getting permits for that. But it looks like we have a fully preserved, untested porphyry center there that's just about, 1.5 kilometers away from Candelaria. We're hoping to get that permitted this year to start drilling next year. At the same time, we're going to be working towards an initial resource estimate at Florida Cobre on the Candelaria Center. And we've already started the metallurgical work there. We're also looking to put together an initial resource estimate for our Elida project. We just finished drilling on that project late last year. And, it's in a different location. It's located north of Lima. It's a big porphyry alteration system that was discovered by globetrotters and put into Element 29. We're pretty excited about getting that, getting an initial resource estimate on that project. And we look to hopefully get back in there in late Q3 to sort of expand on that resource base and to test a couple of other targets as well.
All right. We'll look forward to follow your efforts here. Richard, thanks so much.
Okay. Thank you very much, Christine. Appreciate it.